Powerful prayers against family idols. Before we proceed on that, I want to say a warm welcome to as many of you that are new subscribers. The steps of the righteous are ordered by God, and that is why you're here. Sit back, relax, feel at home, because your joy will be full in the name of Jesus. And to my returning viewers, you have no idea, I am being encouraged. I love you all. May the good Lord keep perfecting all that concerns you and your family in the name of Jesus. Amen. Powerful prayers against family idols. And if you're new to this channel, I want you to know that this is a channel of prayers. As a matter of fact, this topic was from a sister here. She chatted me up and she told me to do a video concerning this topic. She told me she needed prayer points to fight against family idols. And that is one amongst the privileges that you, under the sound of my voice, will be having as a patron. Become a patron to this channel. Become a partner to this channel if you want me to do special videos for you. There are so many persons that want to pray, but they don't know how to pray. They don't know prayer points to guide them towards praying. I am here for you. Just become a partner and the good Lord will keep increasing you and yours in the name of Jesus. Amen. What are family idols? Family idols are deities. You know, there is this song in my country. They call them man-made gods. They have eyes, but they cannot see. They have mouth, but they cannot talk. They have legs, but they cannot walk. You know, they have this, but they cannot, you know, man-made God, I will never worship man-made God. Yes, of a truth, the family idols have eyes, but they cannot see. Good and fine. They've got legs, but they cannot walk. Good and fine. But there is a spirit behind the family idol. Our forefathers were feeding the man-made gods. I have said this here countless times, that if you go to a plain ground, nothing is on that plain ground, just a ground. And you get up in the morning, you see these idol worshippers, they get up in the morning and they go there with a bottle of, you know, schnapp or whatever. And they go there to libate. Oh, you gods of this. Oh, you this of that. Remember, nothing is on that ground. And they are pouring that drink on that ground. Child of God, a wandering spirit, a wandering familiar spirit, a wandering demon that sees that, oh, food is being poured on that ground and nobody is there. Something is being poured on this place and nothing is there. That spirit will go there and dwell. I want you to relax and enjoy this video. Our God loves worship. As a matter of fact, he's a jealous God. And so is the devil. The devil loves worship. No worship is a waste. If you're worshiping, is that you're worshiping God or you're worshiping the devil? You are not just worshiping, you know, nothing. No. It's either you're worshiping God or you are worshiping the devil. And to you that think you're just libating to the floor, and that you're not worshiping the devil, some persons will tell you they don't serve God, they don't serve the devil, they are just there. It is a blatant lie. If you are not worshiping God, you are worshiping the devil. Knowingly or unknowingly. A spirit goes there to dwell. And before you know it, for the fact that that man or woman goes there to libate, remember the spirit now dwells there. Anything that man or woman asks, the spirit begins, that evil spirit begins to walk. Could be negative, could be positive. Why? Because the spirit is being fed by that man. So are the idols from your father's house. So are the idols from your mother's house. Our forefathers did these things unknowingly. Some of them did it for protection. Oh, please protect me and my children. It is never only about them. The same way you under the sound of my voice, when you pray for yourself, you pray for your family, you pray for your children. So we are our grandparents. And that is why it baffles me when some persons will tell you, I never met a family idol. I don't have a business with a family idol, but there is a seasonal occurrence happening in your life. Every said month, you must fall ill. Every said month, somebody dies in the family. At a certain age, somebody dies in the family. It is happening to your father, and you got to that age, it started happening to you. No firstborn survives, above the age 35. Certain unusual seasonal occurrences, repeated occurrences. And you say to yourself that you never met any deity, you never met an idol. Everybody on this planet Earth, there was once an idol in your family. Because the forefathers never knew God. I am telling you the gospel truth. And while they were liberating to those things, whether you believe it or not, they included you. They included you, their third, their fourth, their fifth generation. My children, 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 children. And you're not in this generation. And you think you're not part of it. It is time to be liberated. I just told you a negative illustration. How about the positive illustration? Our father Abraham was a father of prayer. He was the master of altars. Anywhere he went, he built an altar. Anywhere he went, he worshipped God. And he does not just worship God. He made that certain place a consistent worship place for God. And what happened to Jacob? You can go through the book of Genesis chapter 28 from verse 10 down. Jacob went to Haran, a certain place where Abraham has built an altar. I am telling you of a place that an altar was built years before Jacob. But because Abraham has cultivated the seed of prayer at that set place, years after, Jacob went there to dwell. And what happened? He saw angels ascending and descending. That is because the altar of prayers was already planted there by Father Abraham. And that is why I said every family needs these prayers. So you that is seeing this, please don't sit back and relax and say, I am sanctified, I am purified, my fathers never worshipped it. How about your forefathers? Child of God, that idol, you may not be seeing them anymore. But like I said, a spirit was being fed. Could be knowingly, could be unknowingly. A spirit was being fed through the idol. And that spirit still speaks in your life. That spirit still speaks in the life of the family members. That spirit is still there, speaking negative about the family. That spirit is still there. And that is why certain things are happening to you. And that is why certain things are happening to the family members. And that is why it's like when it seems like you're getting close, things shatters. They call it the near success syndrome. Things don't last in your hands. As a matter of fact, it could be in the hands of others and it is flourishing. But when it gets to your hands, it dies. Child of God, we need to pray against the family idol. And the prayers of the family idol is not a child's play prayer. It is a prayer of the violent, taketh it by force. And such prayers are done in the middle of the night. Such separations are done between the hours of 12 a.m. through 3 a.m. Could be 1 hour, could be 30 minutes, but be violent about these prayers. We are about to pray. I'm about to give you the prayer points. At this point, if you're yet to subscribe, please do so. Yes, join us here. Wholeheartedly, join us here. Again, join us on Telegram. I'll be dropping the link because it is through the Telegram that you can, of course, become a patron. I'll also be dropping the Patreon link so that you can partner with us. And of course, give me prayer points. What are those videos you want me to talk about? It is an opportunity to get them. Hallelujah. Before we proceed, if you're facing unexplained circumstances, it could be the family idol. I'm talking about circumstances that you cannot trace. You cannot explain. You don't know why these things keep happening. No love, no peace in the family. Child of God, you know why? These family idols were being fed by our forefathers. And, because they were ignorant, they did not pass it on to the next generation. and to those that passed it on to the next generation. It could be that the new generation have now known Christ. But they have known Christ and they've not known how to renounce those family idols. Now what happens? Some of them go to burn the idols. I've seen situations where they gather these things and they just, grandma is dead, grandpa is dead, nobody's feeding you anymore, and they throw these idols into the sea. And they gather these idols, they burn them. The traditionalists, there's something they will do, some traditional things to shut the mouth of the spirit behind the idol. To cripple, the power or whatever of the spirit behind the idol. But you see, us Christians, I'm a woman of faith. I love faith, You can gather these things and just say, oh, I know you are powerless from this day. You have lost your grip in my life and you burn it. But child of God, there are some powers of darkness that you cannot just gather and throw away like that. The forefathers have served and worshipped these idols for years. And you think just for one day, you can gather these idols and you throw them away. Child of God, no. There are some things that cannot go until you pray and fast. Until you get up in the middle of the night violently and you begin to pray violently. And these are the prayer points I want to give to you. Just preparing your minds to know that this is not just, but by the grace of God, all things will work out for your good because you believe. Hallelujah. Are you set for fire? Are you set to pray? Now, the first prayer point, to fight against the family idol. Open your mouth and say, Father, thank you. I hope you're with your pen and paper so that you can do this at your leisure. And please, I want you to see this video to the end. Because at the end, I'll be telling you what to do before these prayers. There is something you ought to do before these prayers. Hallelujah. Now you say, Father, I thank you, for you are the God that fights my battle. You open your mouth and say, Father, I thank you, because you are the God that fights my battle. Father, I give you all the praise. I hope you're writing this down. Because you are the God, my fighter. You are the God that fights my battle. I give you all the adoration, Lord, because you are the God that fights my battle. Take all the glory now and forevermore in the name of Jesus. Amen. Prayer point number two. Father, in the name of Jesus, I repent of all ancestral idol worship. You begin to repent. You begin to repent. Father, in the name of Jesus, I repent from every ancestral idol worship. Father, I repent. Father, I repent from every ancestral idol worship. In the name of Jesus, I repent. My children repent. My husband repents. On behalf of my family, we repent. In the name of Jesus, I repent from every ancestral idol worship. In Jesus' victorious name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number three. I hope you're writing them down because you're praying violently. Every idol of my father's house, lose your hand over my life. Every idol of my father's house, lose your hand over my life. Every idol of my father's house, malahan tayada, suzahiva gados kalabaya, yegede zegede, endos malahintaya. Every idol of my father's house, lose your hold over my life. At this point, you should be clicking on the subscribe button, because this channel is for the violent. Hallelujah. Prayer point number four. Every strong man from my father's house, fall and die now. Every strong man from my father's house, fall and die now. Every strong man, from my father's house, fall and die now. You know what prompted to this prayer point? I will tell you. My husband, even as we speak, there is a powerless idol in his father's house. An idol that the family members agreed to throw it away. But somebody in the family stood and said no. That this idol has been protecting them, not us. That this idol has been doing this, doing that for them, not I and my family. And as we speak, that idol is still there. Do you know what this strong man does? Because he has seen that I and my household, just like Joshua has said, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. A long time, I and my husband have separated ourselves. We have done these prayers countlessly. We have lost count on how many times we have done this prayer, separating ourselves from every family idol. Ourselves and our children and unborn children to, you know, as long as the generation takes. You know what this man does? He was even saying that, oh, that nobody is worshipping it, but that the idol has been doing things, they should leave it there, and, you know, because he's kind of the eldest, they left it. This man secretly goes to the back to feed this idol against us. You know how somebody can just go there, oh, you idol, take this, fight against Jessica. Take this, fight against Joy. Take this, remember they are not feeding you, I'm the one coming to feed you. Every strong man, hey, from my father's house, fall and die. We woke up one morning and we heard the man is late. Child of God, that strong man has to die for you to be liberated. Somebody is still feeding that idol against you. So don't joke with these prayers. Father, in the name of Jesus, every strong man from my father's house, fall and die now. And so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Amen. Prayer point number 5. I silence the evil cry of my father's house fashioned against me. That cry for blood, that cry for pains, begin to silence it. Those idols were fed and nobody is there again to feed them. Now they are beginning to long for blood. They are beginning to long for pains. They are beginning to long for all forms of negativity. Silence them. I silence the evil cry of my father's house fashioned against me. In the name of Jesus, I silence that evil cry. I silence that evil cry from my father's house, from my mother's house, fashioned against me. In the name of Jesus. Don't joke with these prayers. Prayer point number 6. Every consequences of worshipping the idol, knowingly or unknowingly, I wash myself from that consequence. Now, you know what you will do? When you get to these 6 prayer points, you get a bowl of water. And that is why you need to join us on Telegram. Join us on Telegram. I'll be dropping the link. If you have your anointing oil blessed, you can put a drop in that water. If you don't have, please chat me up or call me. Call me. My number is this on the screen. I don't mind. Call me. So that your oil can be blessed. This 6 prayer points, a drop of oil, of the blessed oil in the water. Every consequences of worshipping the idol, knowingly or unknowingly, I wash myself from that consequences. In the name of Jesus, you begin to wash your hand. I wash myself of that consequences. I don't know how I have worshipped it knowingly or unknowingly. Hey, in the name of Jesus, I wash my hands of it. I wash my face of it. You clean your face. I wash my feet of it. Of every consequences of worshipping this idol, knowingly or unknowingly, in the name of Jesus. Prayer point number 7. Every evil power of my father's house speaking against my destiny, I silence your voice now forever. They are speaking against your destiny. That idol is speaking against the destiny of your children. And that is why it's as if nobody is progressing. Hey, some of them have mental issues. So many things are fighting against you, unknowingly to you. Every evil power of my father's house speaking against my destiny, I silence your voice forever. And so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Amen. Prayer point number 8. I break all ancestral covenants connecting me with the evil powers. Hey! Now these are powers that follows you everywhere you go. The family idol. Don't take these prayers for granted. I've heard somebody say that when she's walking, it seems like somebody is following her at the back. Family idol. But by the time she turns, she doesn't see anybody. But she can hear the footstep following her. Now, this is a monitoring spirit from your father's house. Hey, I break all ancestral covenants connecting me with evil powers. I break that covenant. I separate myself. Violent prayers. And so shall it be. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Prayer point number 9. You begin to plead the blood of Jesus. After separating yourself. After separating yourself from the evil powers. I plead the blood of Jesus all over me. I soak myself into the blood of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus cover me. Let the blood of Jesus fight for me. Let the blood of Jesus protect me. Let the blood of Jesus be a siege of fire around me. Now you have stopped them from monitoring you. You surround yourself with the blood. The perfect blood. The blood that redeems. The blood that saves. The blood that protects. The blood that speaks. Better things than the blood of Abel. The blood of Jesus cover me. The blood of Jesus cover me. From today I am covered. From today I am protected. From today I am liberated. From today I am separated. I am sanctified with the blood of Jesus. You begin to plead. You begin to plead. Make use of that blood. It was given free of charge to you. The blood of Jesus cover me. From today, I am separated from every family idol. From today, I am liberated. I am exempted. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus cover me. Protect me. Fight for me. Be a siege around me. And so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now, the 10th and the last prayer point. I declare I am a new creature, washed by the blood. No idol will have power over me anymore. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare, I am a new creature, washed by the blood. No idol will have power over me anymore. No idol will have strength over me anymore. No idol will speak over me and my family anymore. In the name of Jesus. Then finally, you begin to worship God. Call him names. I love to call him names. The God that sees me, Eroi, King of glory, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Ancient of days, who can fathom? Who is that person that will say yes when you have not spoken? Nobody. I give you all the glory. I worship you, Lord, in the beauty of your holiness. Thank you because you've heard and answered my prayers. In Jesus' victorious name, we have prayed. Amen. Congratulations, child of God. You are liberated. You are protected. You are separated. Provided you have prayed these prayers, you are protected. You are sanctified. You are liberated. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Congratulations. I'm telling you this in advance because I know that the Lord, even by seeing this video, you are separated. But please make sure you do these prayers again at your leisure. Now, why did I tell you to see this video to the end? It's because there is something called a mercy prayer. Yes, even though we prayed about mercy, I think that was the second prayer point. I repent of all ancestral idol worship. That is a repentant prayer. But please, I would like you to set a day aside before you kick on those prayers. Just set a day aside. Use Psalm 51. Pray it all day. You may fast if you want to. If you don't have the strength, do not fast. Just do a one-day mercy prayer. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to your loving kindness. Please, on that day, don't ask for anything. Don't tell God. Don't mistakenly say, oh, Father, help me. Mm-mm. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me. You can be in the office and you do this prayer. Nothing is a constraint to this prayer. Just be conscious. Ask the Holy Spirit to keep reminding you that you are in a mercy prayer. But if you know, probably your free day at work, you can just set that day aside indoors. Pray that mercy prayer from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. at interval. Maybe 1 hour, you just ask God for mercy. You can ask God for mercy by 6 a.m. on the dot. And you're busy for the day, 7 a.m., you ask God for mercy. 8 a.m., you ask God for mercy. You ask him for mercy hourly till it gets to 6 p.m. Then the next day, you get up violently. In the middle of the night, the early hours of the morning, 12 a.m. through 3 a.m., you begin to pray these prayer points. Child of God, I see you breaking free in the name of Jesus. God bless you all. If you're yet to subscribe, please do so. Again, something very important. Always click on the thumbs up. Always click on it to enable this video go viral. Again, share. In this channel, we are not stingy. We ain't self-centered. We reach out to people. You have no idea. So many persons are under the siege of the family idol and they ought to break free just as you have. God bless you all. See you next time. Bye for now.